at the beginning of this film line, we start with the material handling system. These are two big bag emptying station and two bag emptying station. From this system, the raw materials get transported to the receivers, and from there, the material goes into the loss and weight feeders. From the loss and weight feeders, the material gets fed into the twin screw extruder. In this case, this is a ZSE 50 MAXX extruder with a very flexible process length between 36 and 60 LOD. This flexible system can be equipped with side feeders and side degassing systems, and especially for sensitive products which need a very good degassing, we are able to use a frequency controlled dry running vacuum system which allows us to create under pressures up to 10 millibar to get very good mechanical and product qualities. After the extruder, we installed the new Leistritz rheometer, which allows us to measure the shear viscosity and also the elongation viscosity of the compounded materials to have a perfect process control. The next step is the melt pump. The melt pump is necessary for the pressure buildup before the screen changer and also for the flat film die. With this line, we can produce films with a width up to 750 millimeters and a thickness between 0.2 and 1.4 millimeters. The produced melt film gets transported to the Leistritz chill roll, where it's cooled and shaped, and afterward it gets guided to the winding system. This project was realized with our partners NatureWorks and Omia, and the results of the produced film were very good mechanical properties and no degradation of the molecular mass. These excellent results were only possible because of a very good process setup and a special coated calcium carbonate. To summarize, I want to highlight the three most important arguments for an inline compounding process. First, it's a very material sensitive process. Second, it's extremely energy efficient. And third, it's very economical compared to a two-step process.